first, let's talk about Enjoy.
Sure.
What is it? How does it work?
Yeah, it's really simple. You know, when I was at Apple, we built a new channel for Apple, the Apple retail store, and it's become a great way for Apple customers to buy, and it also created a gold standard for buying Apple products. We're now in a world where we've been buying e-commerce, you know, shopping on Amazon for about 25 years, but all it does is get to the door. What Enjoy does is delivers a retail experience in your home by going through the door. So if you order, for example, a new iPhone from AT&T, in the shopping cart it used to pick shipping, now you pick ready to go, which is another word for Enjoy. And one of our trained experts, full-time employees, will bring not only the product you want to buy, you'll have others you can choose, but they'll bring a full retail experience into your kitchen or your family room.
So how does your business model work? Does the consumer pay for it, or do your partners pay for it?
It's completely free.
Well, how do you make money?
Well, because, well, retail stores are expensive. You know, when, like I was at Apple, when you build a store, you have to build out the store, you pay rent, you hire lots of employees, you have to constantly update the store. That costs a lot of money. We now just focus on the experiential part of the retail experience. Imagine if you could take that experience you have at the Apple store, just a person and the product, and transport that into your living room. That'd be a lot lower cost to deliver. And for a lot of companies, you know, in the physical world, premium products invest a lot in their last mile, which is the store. In the online world, we all have the same last mile. It ends up at the doorstep, and the only question is how fast it gets there. Now we go through the door.
So you just closed a new funding round.
Yes.
What are you doing with the money?
We are expanding. So we just announced last week that on October 29th, we'll be in Toronto with a great partnership with Rogers. Rogers is the leading carrier for the Canadian market. We also have been expanding in the UK. We now serve over 60% of the households in the UK through a partnership with British Telecom. And so we're just trying to build out our business, expanding to new countries, new products. It has been really fun.
You've brought up Apple a few times, mm-hmm. so I'd be remiss if I didn't mention some of the recent concerns about the store. Customers say that it feels more about the brand and not so much about the consumer.
Sure.
How do you respond to that?
You know, that has not been my experience. You know, 2 weeks ago on a Sunday, I walked into my local Apple store, knocked on the door, didn't know the employees. I was able to get a new iPhone, activated setup on the spot, great accessories. Last Friday, I was in New York City. I got up early. I went down and went through the new Fifth Avenue Apple store. Mm-hmm. It's the nicest store I've ever been to of any type. So I think Apple's doing a lot really great. Retail's hard, though. It's detail. And when you have busy stores, you're not going to be perfect. But I know everyone at Apple's doing their best to deliver a great experience every time.
You talk about retail, you're also at JCPenney, mm-hmm. for example. What do you make of some of these, just the shift in the general landscape as you take a look at the retailers? Companies like JCPenney struggling, and then you have other companies like Walmart really getting it.
Yeah.
How do you differentiate yourself?
Customers are really savvy, mm-hmm. and they want newness. They want newness in products they buy, they want newness in shopping experiences. So companies that are kind of in the middle that haven't been updating their stores and their websites and their product, I call tired. And the customer doesn't like to go to tired retail. You know, they want things that are new and exciting and vibrant. We're in a world now, though, where we are post-digital. You know, the disruption from online shopping is over. All of the great physical retailers that have figured out how to compete, their stocks are at all-time high. Target, Walmart, Best Buy. Well, because they've got advantages built in. You know, if I'm a Target customer, I can order online and have it delivered to me. I can just drive and pick it up if I want to get it now. I can pick it up and go to the store. I can shop the old-fashioned way. Even in the store, there's lots of technology deployed. There are more places to check out on your own now, just with easy scanning, than standing in line. So the retail stores have fought back, and so the better stores have never been better. But the problem is we're overstored in the country. So a lot of these mid-large retailers like Macy's and Penney's and Sears, and they don't really have a great future because it's hard.
So we'll give you the last word on Enjoy.
Sure.
What's the next thing you're going to take the company?
Well, the next thing will be next year when you will see all of these Enjoy mobile stores driving around town. And we'll go, where were they? Were they hiding in plain sight?
Mobile stores.
Everyone will see us next year.